Hey, folks, a warm and humid night across the valley. Temperatures still upper 70s and low 80s, and our normal high this year is just in the mid-80s, so we're not far off of that even as we speak. Of course, things are going to change. Not so much tonight. We stay in the 70s all night long tonight. That's where you are at 8 o'clock in the morning. You head off to work or school. And by middle of the afternoon, we're in the 90s in most areas. Some parts of the valley may reach the mid-90s tomorrow afternoon as we await the arrival of the front. Now, this model says front moves in about 11 o'clock, and by 4 in the morning, we're all down around 50 or so. Continue to drop into the 40s by 8 o'clock on Thursday morning. So we go from upper 70s tomorrow morning to upper 40s on Thursday morning. That is a huge drop from one day to the next. And then it just stays chilly all day. By 1 o'clock, we're about 50 or so. By the time you get to 7 o'clock, if you're out trick-or-treating, you're still looking at mid-50s with a northerly breeze. I do think the clouds go away. Maybe some late-day sunshine. That helps warm the temperatures back to these numbers. But with the north wind, it's still going to feel pretty cool. By Friday morning, now we're looking at mid-40s across the area. So a cold start under mainly clear skies. Not a whole lot of wind, so it may not feel so bad Friday morning just because the wind is gone. And by afternoon, then we climb back in the 60s. If you look at the 7-day temperature trends, we go from 90s tomorrow to 50s on Thursday. And we'll spend a lot of the day in the 40s likely on Thursday for Halloween. And then we're back to the 60s for Friday and Saturday. Weak front on Saturday holds us steady. And then we warm up for the first of next week once again. Not much on satellite and radar tonight. Future track, again, this one of the faster models shows spotty stuff tomorrow, but not much. But by the time you get late in the day tomorrow, this is 4 in the afternoon, scattered showers start to pop up ahead of the front. This model brings the front through with scattered showers and storms during the dinner hour, right after the dinner hour, about 8 o'clock tomorrow night, pushes it on through. The clouds and showers linger for a time behind it through much of the night. I think there'll probably still be clouds and maybe leftover showers when you first get up on Thursday morning, but the rain will go away and eventually the clouds will thin out too. So here are your rain chances. During the daytime tomorrow, about 10%. Tomorrow night and early Wednesday, that's our best chance, and it tapers off after that and goes away by Friday. So you see we drop it off, and for the most part, then we're dry after that through the rest of the forecast period into early next week. So the front is stalled to the north. It will slowly settle southward tonight, but eventually low pressure is going to develop up here, and that'll just shove the front right down into the valley. Chilly temperatures build in. Again, clouds may linger into the early afternoon with some late-day sunshine. After that, it looks like we're back to some sunshine again, but the chilly weather lasts all the way through Friday. So here's your updated First 15 AccuWeather forecast for tonight. Partly cloudy, a little fog. It's still warm and humid tonight, but then tomorrow back to 92 late in the day. Showers and storms with that front. We say late in the day, we're talking primarily during the evening and late night hours. By the time you get to Thursday, windy, cold, some showers early, probably some late day sunshine, but only 57 for a high. Back to 69 on Friday. We hold at 68 on Saturday. Yes, this is the weekend. You set your clock back. Next week, we're back in the 80s once again. That's your updated First 15 AccuWeather forecast.